This is Star Citizen. And this is the Space Mouse from 3D Connection. When I first saw it, I knew it had to be perfect for games like Star Citizen, where you fly spaceships that are capable of moving and rotating in every direction. This is called 6 Degree of Freedom, and with a controller like the Space Mouse, you can control them all at once. However, since the Space Mouse isn't designed for being a game controller, using it as such out of the box won't work. This does not mean that it cannot function as a joystick, as it is more than capable of doing so. You just have to tell the driver what to do and in what application or game to do it in. Let me show you how to set it up for Star Citizen. I assume you have installed the software for the Space Mouse 3DXWare. When you open it, you see that it will focus on the application currently in the foreground. This is also how the configuration works. There are many predefined configurations, but sadly Star Citizen is not one of them. It will keep one configuration for each application it is used for. Start by keeping the 3DXWare application open on the desktop, and then open Star Citizen. Wait until it has started and is in the module selection menu. Then Alt-Tab to the 3DXWare application and notice that it has focus on Star Citizen. Click on Advanced Settings, then activate all 6 directions by selecting Pan, Zoom and Rotation. Then close and select Buttons. Select the Escape key for all buttons and then close. You have now created a basic configuration file for Star Citizen. Notice that the file is in your user folder under App Data, Roaming, 3D Connection, 3DXWare, CFG. If App Data is not visible in your user folder, then click on the Path Input field and write it manually. Then continue browsing until you get to the Star Citizen KMJ file. KMJ stands for Keyboard Mouse Joystick. Let's open the file and have a look at it. You can use whatever text editing tool you like. I'm using the free Visual Studio Code from Microsoft. As you can see, this configuration will be used when Star Citizen is running. This is the lateral X, Y, and Z axes. This is the rotational X, Y, and Z axes. And this is the configuration for button 1 and button 2. They all have input and output attributes. The input attributes should be okay, and we need to focus on changing the output attributes. We change the part that says multi-axis to joystick for all axes. If rotational X is set to hid mouse wheel, copy from input to output first and then change multi-axis to joystick. Do the same for the buttons. Copy from input to output, and then change button to joystick. You have now configured the Space Mouse to work correctly as a joystick in Star Citizen. We now need to configure Star Citizen to work with the Space Mouse as a joystick. Open up Star Citizen and wait until it's in the module selection window. Click on Options, Keybindings, select Joystick HOTAS, then Advanced Controls Customization, open up Flight Movement, then double-click on Pitch, Yaw and Roll, and move the Space Mouse in the direction you want to set these for. Make sure they are set for X, Y and Z axis rotation, and that it shows input in parentheses. Notice the input number as you need it later. Then scroll down and do the same for strafe up down, strafe left right and throttle forward back. Make sure the same is done here. You want X, Y and Z axis, and that input is shown in parentheses. If it's missing, just do the same again until it's correct. After you've assigned functions to the Space Mouse, click on Controls. Then select Joystick HOTAS, and the number from the input before. Open Inversion Settings. Then Flight. Then Flight Movement. And select Yes for Pitch, Roll, up-down, and forward-backward. You should now try out the new joystick you've set up for Star Citizen. Since not all systems are the same, you might need to change some settings to get it just right. Good luck and see you in the next patch.